Hey everybody, Sweaty Zeus. We are now in Pure Black Tendency and Stone Fading Tome, so we can go ahead and take out the primeval demon. You don't have to be in body form. This is, I like being in body form. Once I take care of the world tendency stuff, just because I enjoy having a little extra health for a change. Okay, so now this part's interesting, and if you don't see where I'm at, maybe you can tell now. Or at the beginning area. It's that elevator right at the start, and you just want to take it to the bottom. But we cannot use, we can't warp, basically. So, we just gotta be sure not to do that. And we're gonna try to get back to that guy, Skurver, I think, maybe? The guy who wanted to see the Dragon Bone Smasher. Should be able to max this out now. That's maxed. We got the bow maxed. So we're looking good, really. I'm not going to replace this with... Well, let me get off the elevator first. I'm really terrible about, like, doing stuff in the world and, like, trying to... No! You gotta be kidding me. Well, fuck that up. What I was trying to do, God, I hate hitting that button by accident. Where'd that stupid soul go? God. Oh, I'm so mad. So I guess we won't be able to do it now. I don't know. I've never... Since we didn't hit an archstone, I don't know if it matters or how that works, but anyways, I'll show you what you need to do, and you can do it yourself since you're probably better than I am. Take my rage out on these guys. You can see the phantom now because we're in black tendency. But he still ain't shit. There's a couple of them up there, too. But what I was gonna say is, since we can't use the archstone, you just gotta run to the second area. Because... After you kill the primordial demon, see, it probably already did it. No, we're still in pure dark. I guess you just can't warp. I thought you couldn't die, but I guess you can die. Whoa! Die, fat boy. I'm a little jazzed up, if you can't tell. So there'll be a phantom up here too, I think. Not the first one, but the second one. They just hit a little harder. It's nothing to really worry or write home about. Just want to make note of it. See, almost tap circle again, which would have made me do a back step. I've died like that in every Souls game, like at least once. Usually a few times. I think these guys might be here again, these lizards. No? Did we? Oh, it's the other one. Never mind. It's the other elevator that goes down. So this is the archdome we go to get the crystal lizards. We're going to hang it right. We need to equip some grass, don't we? Excuse me. Whoops. There we go. I'm trying to line some of these up. We got several at them. So we're trying to get down to where we were. I think I'm looking like I need some grass too, don't I? Hope I actually can fix that. So this one's pretty easy to get to. We're just gonna roll off. Next one. So we can go in body form here. This guy's kind of tough, so that's why I don't want to use a lot of those. Let's see. I guess we could take those guys out with our bow. I didn't realize I've been using regular arrows all the time. It's much better. Wow, how many items are in front of that guy? Alright, let's see what this does. Because he's just going to straight up run and attack you. That's what I thought. It does nothing. This guy's so tough. He does monster damage. The best tactic is to try to get him to roll off over here. And I pushed him off, I think, the first time I played this. That's what happened. I'll kind of take it for a little bit, but... Some de-aggro. I guess if he'll keep doing that, we could just do that to him. I've never seen him do that. Normally he will just charge. Yeah, I think he's aggroed now. Maybe not. Nice lead shot, huh? Yeah, we're doing damage to him slowly but surely. Thought I had a lot more arrows than that. ahead and turn around, buddy. I think he's too close now. No, turn around. Yes! You idiot. He's really tough. Like, I've died to him a few times. Oh, that was annoying. Like, the last couple times I went through there, he wouldn't fall off, like, no matter what I did. And, so his stuff will be over here now. And there's the Talisman of Beast. Which I missed that stupid item again. That is, it's just a soul, but I'll come back and get it myself. I'm not gonna torture you with getting that. Really, all you gotta do is go down. I dropped down that way last time I came here. Just drop down to that side after the first one. But it's not that hard. But like I said, it's just a soul item. So, you know, don't kill yourself to get it. It's either that or grass. I can't remember. I just know it's not like a weapon or anything ridiculously important. This is just the easiest way down, the way I've taken because of the boss, you know. You kind of learn the easiest way to path to the boss. Especially when you die to him a few times. So, actually, I can show you how to get that, well, it might be too far down to get that item. So to get that other item, you just want to drop down here. But the best advice I can give you, instead of just running off, I would roll from like back here. So start walking here and then roll far away. But angle kind of like towards the wall just a little bit. Because what happens if you run off, that little outcropping will push you out. And then it'll push you over that edge. It's happened to me a few times. So... And then when you drop off this one, I always recommend to walk out on that little ledge part. So it makes it easier to drop down. Alright. Is this the one? No, we still gotta go further. Maybe we can get to that item. Anyways. Here we go. Oh, I was wrong. That's the plague resist ring. glad we came and got it. It's a little embarrassing, right? That would have been helpful when we were fighting old girl with the crossbow in Latria several episodes ago. But it's okay. We made it. Okay, so we're trying to get down there. This one's kind of awkward. Just try to roll over that little post there. You can kind of get hung up on it, but... And then you can roll down there, but... To be honest, I like to get all these little things out of the way, because I've tried to do it before and got pushed away from the wall and fall into my death and had to do it all over again. So, we're just gonna... Oh, I want to take those out down there, too. Little bug carapaces. So we're just gonna run off here and roll. See how it kind of pushes you back? So, alright, so we're finally to this area. The reason I'm not running is there's a few drops here, and I'm just trying to avoid them. So there's some crystal lizards back there. You can either run by that guy and just smash him, or if you want to try to draw him out, you can do that too. But he's so slow. It's kind of the only downside with trying to draw him out. Here we go. Alright. Still swinging at the one that was clearly already dead. That's good. We need a few more of those stones. You can go ahead and use it if you want. Oh, we did forget something though. Dang it. You do want to put on, there's a couple spells that you really want to use for this area. We'll take care of it though. I always forget to prepare for these areas. This is the corner of the guys around, I think. Nope. I'm just talking out my ass, aren't I? There's one of the little drops. And then that brings us. Try to set that off. Whew! Thought we'd get further away than that. Number two. Roll away. Or back away then. We got pretty good distance too, so just try to get back as good as you can. Dragonstone upgrades fire weapons. So, I think because we were in white earlier that fire sword wasn't there. Fire longsword. The one I was talking about that was out, it was that shield, and I didn't think it, I thought it was going to be a sword. And this just wise off, I forgot, and then comes back together, so it's insignificant. But, yeah, so the dragonstone shards and chunks and all that are what'll upgrade your fire weapons, like, you know, like fire sword I was talking about. I think there's a, is this it? Okay, yeah, and this brings us out to this area we came out on earlier. To approach and see if maybe that item came back. No? I'm gonna check that real quick here in a minute. Just pause this and look and make sure. I've never heard about that being a tendency. I just thought it was always there. This is the one thing I don't like about, you know, these tenancy events and all that, is, I don't know, they just, like, they're easy to mess up, and I don't like feeling, like, gatekeeped in the, you know, like, where certain quests or you can't do them anymore, and so, it's just, like, you're always, instead of just playing the game and having fun, you're, like, having to, like, be like really careful and, you know, cautious. Like, it just takes a little bit of the fun away, in my opinion. But it's still a great game. I'm not trying to rag on it. Is that it? No, it's this one. So I don't know if we'll be able to survive this. We probably won't, to be honest. At least we have that. But we should have put on, I forget the name of it, but there, it's a spell that covers you in, water so you can survive the, lava. Especially since we're not really using our fire ones down here. I really could have thrown that on easily, but sorry for breaking it. I don't think you can do this area without it, to be honest. We'll, oh, everything's gonna blow up. We'll try and see how much we can take of the, better than I thought, but I still don't think we're gonna be able to make it. Especially we don't have much grass left, so we just have two. Let's see how far we can get here. Set. Like, I know we can cross it, but the problem is going to be getting all the items. There it is. I was just wrong about where it's placed, apparently. I don't know what I was thinking. I don't know why I was thinking that that was out there. Maybe I was thinking about the upgrade materials, because that guy sells them that's like out there on that ledge. I don't know. I apologize for that, though. It was definitely not worth that. Uh-oh, boys. We're not gonna make it very far. Should we try to... Probably should try to get out of here, huh? Ooh! I guess we could heal up and try to get the rest of it. Y'all probably don't wanna sit and watch that, though. Which I totally understand. Just need that one. Can't remember if there's something. Trying not to get burned at all. We did. That's alright, we'll come back. I'll go get that spell. We'll come back and, you know, make that area a little bitch, so. If we have enough souls. Which I don't think. It might be 5,000. We've got a couple we can sell, though. A few boss souls we're not going to use, so. I'd like to get Evacuate too, which is actually a faith.
Bravo, thank you. Let me buy him one.
Got
human I am fully prepared.
You saved, then I was right. I'm great, do you see?
What is it? Oh, it's better than having you bother.
What? Is it a, faith? I thought it was a magic.
Oh, is that? Do you have further off? Yes. I see.
My eye, Umbasa. With thanks to his, isn't it wonderful?
Where's the other? Is he the one you buy the other souls or souls from? She's just there. She doesn't do anything. My character tendency. No, it's not black yet. Okay. I swore it was Shriek that sold it. Did I just miss it?
Thank you.
Maybe I already bought it. That's what it is. I think I already bought it, yeah. That's what it is. No? Yeah, Water Veil. Okay. And we had an empty slot for it. So we have... Or we don't have warding. But let's go ahead and actually... Get rid of that and that. Warding. So we got Warding, Soul Ray, and Water Veil. So we can throw on Warding and Water Veil. And I don't know, but I think warding will help. Where'd you go? I think warding will help the whatchamacallit. Oh, we need arrows. No, we're good on arrows, actually. Warding will help the fire accumulation. I'm not sure about that, but I think so. So. Let's see where we're on time. Okay. Got enough time to finish this area. I'll be right back. I'm gonna pause, but you should notice on the video.
Yes!